So, question three from June 2005 says express this expression in partial fractions. So, standard partial fractions question, we know that 5x plus 3 all over 2x minus 3 x plus 2 can be written in the form, because they're distinct linear factors, we can write them in the form a over the first factor plus b over the second factor. And our job is to find out what a and b are. So if we multiply both sides by this double bracket here, we're actually going to get the expression 5x plus 3 is equal to a. 2x minus 3 is going to cancel. It's going to give us ax plus 2. And the x plus 2 is going to cancel. So it's going to give us b brackets 2x minus 3. Now, there's a number of ways you can solve partial fraction questions. You can either take coefficients of x and constants and work it out. In this case, it's quite nice if we let x equal minus 2. Now, the reason we let x equals minus 2 is because in this bracket here will equal to 0. So if we need x equal minus 2, 5 plus or minus 2 is minus 10, plus 3 is minus 7, is equal to b lots of, well, 2 lots of minus 2 is minus 4, minus 3 is minus 7b on the right-hand side. That gives us nice, easy expression. B is 1. Now, if we equate coefficients of x, we get on the left-hand side 5, it's the only thing multiplied by x. On the right-hand side, we're going to get a times x, so the coefficient, the number bit is a, and this bit side, we're going to get 2b. So we can use our value of b from before, so we can substitute that in, and we find that 5 is a plus 2, or we find out that a is 3. So that's our first answer. That's our second answer. So expressing the original expression, we can actually write the original expression as this. We can write it as 3 over 2x minus 3 plus 1 over x plus 2, as required. Okay, leading to the second part, question B, we're going to need that information because it does use the phrase hence find the exact value of this expression here. So if we call this expression I, really we can rewrite I as the integral of both of the partial fractions. So we can rewrite it the integral from 2 to 6 of 3 over 2x minus 3 with respect to x plus the integral from 2 to 6 of 1 over x plus 2 with respect to x. Okay, so we can then integrate each of these bits in turn. So this first one, we're going to get, well, we're going to get a 3 over 2 log 2x plus 2x minus 3 from this. From this expression here, we can see that the top is almost the integral of the bottom, slight difference. So we're going to get the 3 from the top to ln 2x minus 3, and we're going to get, from this one, we're just going to get a straight integrate 1 over x plus 2 goes to ln x plus 2, and this is all between 2 and 6. Technically, these should be modulus signs, not brackets. And then we can go through and just evaluate it. So let's put the value in when we do put the value of 6 in. So we get 3 over 2 ln 2 times 6 is 12 minus 3 is 9. 3 over 2 ln 9 plus, put 6 into this, is ln 8. Take away. Now the same thing in square brackets, but this time so I'm just using 2 in. So we get 3 over 2 ln 2 lots of 2 is 4 minus 3 is 1. And then we get, sticking 2 into here, we get a log 4. So 2 plus 2, so plus 4. Close it. Now we're going to use a number of facts here. We know that this expression is equal to 0 because log 1 is 0. Now we're going to use the power to the front law here because it does say leaving our answers as a single logarithm. So let's try and get them all in log something first. So power to the front, or move this power up here. 9 to the 3 over 2 is square of 9, which is 3, cubed is 27. So this is really ln 27. This is ln 8. And then we've got from this over here, we're minus in ln 4. So really what we've got to do is, well, we can use the log law. Subtracting logs is going to give us ln 27. You can do this all in one go, of course, but this is going to give you ln 2 because you're dividing the 8 by the 4 because you're subtracting logarithms. Now we're using the other log law, which is when you're adding them, you're multiplying. So a single log theorem is ln 2 times 27 is 54. Okay. Now, just to recap up here, this integration here, you must know the standard patterns for integrating a fraction like this. You could have used a substitution for u equals 2x minus 3 and put that in there, and that would have worked out fine. Or you could have just spotted the standard patterns of adjusting it by the over 2 because of the 2x here. Okay, I'll leave you to replay the video and look at that. Okay, thanks.